This is an ANC special coverage. I'm Gigi Grande. Let's now go to the PICC live for the proclamation of the last three winning senatorial candidates, Cynthia Villar, JV Ejercito, and Gringo Honasan. Nancy Binay and Koko Pimentel are also attending the ceremonies.
Is now in session. Silence is thereby enjoined. Please remain standing.
Please remain standing for the national anthem.
Bayang mag-iliw, pero sa silanganan, alam ng puso sa dibdib mo'y buhay. Lupang hinirang, buyan ka ng mag-iliw, sa manlulupit, kita pasisigil.
Yes, can we request the to sit down?
Please take your seats.
Madam Clerk, can you read the resolution?
And the matter of the canvass and proclamation of the 12 winning candidates for senators as duly elected senators of the Republic of the Philippines and the May 13, 2013 automated national and local elections. NBOC resolution number 0004-13 promulgated May 18, 2013. The dispositive portion of the resolution reads, now therefore, by virtue of the powers vested in it under the Constitution, the Omnibus Election Code, Batas Pambansa Bilang 881, Republic Acts Number 9369, 8436, 7166, 6646, and other election laws, the Commission on Elections, setting in bank as the National Board of Canvassers, declares the following as duly elected senators of the Republic of the Philippines and the May 13, 2013 national and local elections. Ejercito Joseph Victor G. Ejercito Estrada J.V. Honasan Gregorio V. Honasan Gringo. Villar Cynthia A. Villar Cynthia Hanit Buhay. By virtue of this, the National Board of Canvassers now proclaims the following as duly elected senators of the Republic of the Philippines and the May 13, 2013 national and local elections to serve for a term of 6 years, beginning on June 30, 2013, in accordance with Article 6, Section 4 of the Constitution of the Republic of the Philippines. Angara Juan Edgardo M., Binay Maria Lourdes Nancy S., Cayetano Alan Peter, Escudero Francis Joseph G., Ligarda Lorna Regina B., Liamansares Mary Grace P., Aquilino Paulo Benigno 4A, Pimentel Aquino Martin III D., Trillanes Antonio 4F, Ejercito Joseph Victor G., Honasan Gregorio B., Villar Cynthia A., so ordered, signed, Sixto S. Brillantes Jr. Chairman, signed, Lucinito and Tagli Member, signed, Eliasar Yusuf Member, signed, Christian Robert Eslim Member, signed, Maria Gracia Shelo M. Padaka, signed, Al A. Pareño, signed, Louis Tito F. Guia Member.
We will proceed now to present the certificate of proclamation to each of the winners.
Commission on Elections, National Board of Canvassers, we, the chairman and commissioners of the Commission on Elections, sitting and bank as the National Board of Canvassers, hereby proclaim Maria Lourdes Nancy Binay as senator-elect in the May 13, 2013 automated national and local elections. Done the 16th day of May 2013, at the Philippine International Convention Center, City of Pasay, Philippines. Signed, the chairman and all the commissioners.
Congratulations.
Sino siya natigaw? Si ano? Kom Yusuf? Si ano?
We, the chairman and commissioners of the Commission on Elections, sitting and bank as the National Board of Canvassers, hereby proclaim Aquilino Martin D. Pimentel III as senator-elect in the May 13, 2013 automated national and local elections. Done this 17th day of May 2013 at the Philippine International Convention Center, City of Pasay, Philippines. Congratulations.
We, the Chairman and Commissioners of the Commission on Elections, sitting in Bank as the National Board of Canvassers, hereby proclaim Joseph Victor G. Ejercito as Senator-elect in the May 13, 2013 automated national and local elections, done this 18th day of May 2013 at the Philippine International Convention Center, City of Pasay, Philippines, signed by the Chairman and all the Commissioners.
National Board of Canvassers, we, the Chairman and Commissioners of the Commission on Elections, sitting in Bank as National Board of Canvassers, hereby proclaim Gregorio B. Honasan as Senator-elect in the May 13, 2013 automated national and local elections. Then this 18th day of May 2013 at the Philippine International Convention Center, City of Pasay, Philippines. Signed, Sexto is Brillantish Junior Chairman and all the commissioners.
Gringo, congratulations.
Mr. Chairman, salamat.
Congrats, huh? Yeah.
Congratulations, sir.
Pag-isip mo dito, pumesto muna. Chairman, higit na. Okay, muna. Okay. Umiyan na lang. Sige po.
Thank you, Chairman. Salamat.
We, National Board of Canvassers, we, the Chairman and the Commissioners of the Commission on Elections, sitting in Bank as the National Board of Canvassers, hereby proclaim Cynthia A. Villar as Senator-elect in the May 13, 2013 automated national and local elections, done this 18th day of May 2013 at the Philippine International Convention Center, City of Pasay, Philippines, signed Chairman and all the Commissioners.
Congratulations, po. Cynthia, congratulations. Ayan, si Chairman, tatabi na natin siguro, kukuha na ng picture.
Di ba kataas kamay? Siguro. Chair, ikaw na yung taas kamay. Taas kamay. Taas kamay. Ikaw.
Pero tabi natin to. Tabi natin to.
Your fingers. kasi inipat mo dito.
And RG Cruz now joins us live from the PICC. RG?
Hi, Gigi. We just finished with the proclamation of the remaining senators for the next Congress. These are Cynthia Villar, J.V. Ejercito, and Gregorio Honasan. Their proclamation was announced by Chairman Sixto Brillantes after the canvass of the last provincial COC, which came from Lanao del Norte. By the end of that canvass, Gregorio Honasan, who was the 12th placer, pulled away by almost or by more than 700,000 votes against his closest rival for that last slot, who is former Senator Richard Gordon. But aside from these three, Nancy Binay and Koko Pimentel also attended the proclamation rites tonight. You will remember that in the last few days, Senators-elect Binay and Senator Pimentel skipped their proclamations on Thursday and on Friday because they had doubts about the ongoing tally and with the way the COMELEC, or sitting as the NBOC, proceeded with their proclamation. But now, I think all of those questions are moot and academic, and I think even they would agree that's why they showed up here. We had a chance to talk to Senator Koko Pimentel earlier, and he said that he now felt more comfortable coming here now after seeing that most of the certificates of canvass are already in. I have to mention, though, Gigi, that there are still uncanvassed certificates of canvass, and these are from the overseas absentee voting diplomatic posts. However, the COMELEC doesn't expect the final results to be altered by these OAV votes because their voter turnout, they are pegging voter turnout to around just about 117,000 votes. So it's really statistically impossible for Senator Gordon to catch up now, even if he gets all of those OAV votes and Senator Honasan gets nothing. Just to give you a brief run through of what happened earlier, this is a familiar sight that we saw in the last 2 days. It's a very simple program. It began, of course, with the usual, the national anthem, and then it proceeded with the reading of the proclamation resolution proclaiming all 12 as winners of the May 2013 elections. And then they were given or presented, all the candidates present were presented with copies of the certificates of proclamation. The different commissioners took turns reading the certificate of proclamation before these were handed to each candidate. We also earlier how the family members and supporters of the candidates came in to grace the occasion to support, to show their support for their duly elected, for their elected family member. We saw former President Joseph Estrada, San Juan City Mayor Gia Gomez, who are the parents of J.V. Ejercito. We saw the Villar family with outgoing Senator Manny Villar, who is now going to be replaced in the Senate by Senator Cynthia Villar. Of course, we saw the daughter Camille and Las Piñas representative Mark Villar. We also saw Vice President Jojo Binay, accompanied by his wife, Dr. Elinita Binay, as well as the rest of the clan, supporting Nancy, who is their third child, by the way, who is in politics after Makati Mayor Jejumar Binay, and of course Makati Representative Abby Binay. Gigi?
RG, as you mentioned, the names of all the 12 winners of the senatorial elections were read earlier, but the names were still read in alphabetical order. They still were not read with the number of votes obtained by each candidate. They were not ranked according to who obtained the most number of votes. And this is precisely the issue that Attorney Macalintal had raised in the last 2 days. Is this still something that Attorney Macalintal is going to pursue as an issue? Has anybody filed any formal objections because of that?
Gigi, I don't think Attorney Macalintal will be filing any more objections. Remember that Attorney Macalintal is the counsel for Gregorio Honasan, who is the 12th placer. And earlier, We had a chance to talk to him, and he already said that he's not pursuing any more move against the NVOC.
Mm-hmm. But what about Senator-elect Trillanes?
Okay, Senator-elect Trillanes, we got word that he's still out of the country, so that's why he's not here. But we really have no information if he will ask for his own proclamation ceremony. But if ever that happens, that's not going to happen here at the PICC anymore. By tomorrow, or immediately after tonight's program, the COMELEC will start dismantling, and in fact, it has already started dismantling its operations here at the PICC to move back to the main COMELEC headquarters at Palacio del Gobernador in Intramuros, Manila.
Mm-hmm. Now, RG, also earlier you talked about the votes that were cast by the overseas absentee voters, about 117,000 votes from different embassies and consulates abroad. They're going to, you know, want their votes counted still, because a lot of them took the trouble and made the effort of going to the embassies and taking time off from work in order to cast their votes. How will their votes still matter in this election?
Definitely, Gigi, their votes will be canvassed. They will be made part of the official record. But I think the commission saw that it was already statistically impossible for their votes to actually matter insofar as the 12th and the 13th slot. In fact, Chairman Brillantes in the past, and the members of the commission have in the past, encouraged them, all 900,000 of them, to go out and vote, so that the voices of the OFWs through the ballots will matter more in the elections. Can you just imagine if all 975, or at least 75% of all the 975,000 plus OAV voters went out and exercised their right to vote, then they would have been a more formidable voice in this election.
Mm-hmm. Are the overseas absentee voters, did they not have the opportunity to participate in the party list elections?
Remember, Gigi, that under the OAV system, overseas absentee voters, or all absentee voters, whether local or overseas, are allowed to vote for national positions. These are the for Senate and party list. And this is why, going back to your question earlier, this is where their votes will matter, because the computation for who wins party list seats is a little more complicated compared to the computation for the senatorial race. The senatorial race is just a matter of who gets the most votes. But in the party list elections, there are certain percentages that will have to be reckoned with by the Commission on Elections as against the number of available seats. I understand that for the 16th Congress, 58 congressional seats will be given to winning party-less groups. And it is here where the OAV voters will matter. Actually, it is in the party-less elections where every last vote will matter. Gigi.
Thanks very much for that update. RG Cruz there reporting from the PICC. And that was the proclamation of the last three winning senatorial bets, Cynthia Villar, JV Ejercito, and Gringo Honasan, along with Nancy Binay and Koko Pimentel. This formalizes Team Pinoy's 9-3 victory over UNA in the midterm elections. Based on the COMELEC's tally, Grace Po is on top of the so-called Magic 12, followed by re-electionists Lauren Legarda, Francis Escudero, and Alan Peter Cayetano, all from Team Pinoy. Nancy Binay is UNA's front runner at fifth place. She's followed by more Team Pinoy bets, Sunny Angara, Bam Aquino, Koko Pimentel, Antonio Trillanes, and Cynthia Villar. UNA's JV Ejercito and Gringo Honasan complete the winning list. And this has been an ANC special coverage. I'm Gigi Grande. Keep it here on ANC News 24/7.